Hello there, I'm Christian and you're watching A Dev Story. Today I'm continuing the series of videos where I talk about the different type of technical interviews, and today it's the turn for the most famous one, the mythical, the only live coding test. So let's look into that. The live coding test is the most famous one. It's also called the whiteboard interview, but it can also be not only done in a whiteboard, but on paper, or it could be over an online shared document, for example. It's most commonly used in bigger tech companies. It lasts about 1 hour, and the type of questions are usually competitive programming-like exercises. You will find a lot of these exercises online, and even in books like Cracking the Coding Interview. The type of questions could be something like, find a missing number in an array, solve the Hanoi Towers problem, invert a balanced tree, or it could also be a modified data structure or algorithm. For example, implement a queue using a stack. And depending on the level that you're applying for, sometimes the problem might be hidden. For example, the question could be something like, say we sell some products and we are looking into different ways to bundle them to add more value to our customers. How would you do it? In this case, you need first to clarify the requirement. For example, what does it mean to provide value? And then after you start discussing with the interviewer, you get to the actual algorithm that you need to solve. For example, in this case, it would be find all the subsets of a set. The main pro for both the candidate and the interviewer is that this is a very time-efficient process. For the interviewer, a well-designed exercise allows you to get a lot of the skills of the candidate in just 1 hour. You will get to see the technical skills, the soft skill, how do they present themselves, how do they present the ideas, how do they take feedback, for example. Also, usually the focus is in computer science fundamentals, so you don't need to get tangled up, for example, with very specific APIs or technologies. For the candidate, it's almost the same thing. In 1 hour, you're able to showcase a lot of your skills, your technical and soft skills, for example. And also, since the focus is usually in computer science fundamentals, you don't need to care too much about typos or, for example, not using the latest APIs. The main cons for the interviewer is that this is not a real setting of the day-to-day work. It's not a reflection of how the person will do, because not many people, if any, actually write code on a whiteboard the first time they look into a problem. Also, keeping the candidate experience can be hard because the person is already stressed out for the interview or also needing to stand up in front of other people explaining a problem that they are seeing for the first time, maybe, can be very challenging. But we will look into how to solve this in the tips section. For the candidate, the main cons are that it can be a very stressful type of interview, especially for introverts. Since you are not used to have this on your day-to-day, it can be something very hard to deal with during the interview process. Also, if the exercise is not very well designed and it only has very specific solution that you need to know the trick how to do it, you might even fail the interview just because you couldn't get it in 1 hour. And sometimes you might even provide a solution, but if it's not the optimized solution that the interviewer is looking for, you might still fail the interview. The main tips for the interviewer are first to design or pick a problem that has many solutions and different degrees of completeness. This way the candidate has different ways to tackle this problem. Also, make sure that the candidate finishes at least one version of the problem in order to avoid frustration and have a good candidate experience. For the candidate, the main tips are practice competitive programming exercises, but don't do it on an IDE or even a computer. Do it on a whiteboard or on paper. Also, try to record yourself and review it to get more feedback. If possible, try to practice with a colleague, and there are even paid services online that you can hire in order to practice this type of interviews. It's very important to be very vocal during the interview. This way, the interviewer can get insights into your thought process, and this sometimes can be even more important than solving the problem. Finally, also related to being vocal, be sure to state your assumptions during the resolution of the problem. Instead of just jumping to solve the problem when you get asked about it, try to clarify the assumptions with the interviewer first. And that's it for today. That was the most famous interview, the live coding interview. What do you think about it? Have you experienced it before? Do you think it's very stressful? Do you think it's a good way to measure the candidate's skills? Let me know what you think in the comment sections below. With this, we are almost done with the type of technical interview series. There's only one more video that I'm missing that is about other type of technical interviews. So if you don't want to miss it, just subscribe to my channel and keep an eye for it. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time. Bye.